The import RS file method is one of the most widely used methods to add references into your EndNote library. In this video, I will show you how you can build your EndNote library using the import RS file method. As mentioned earlier, this method of adding references is one of the most widely used methods when using EndNote. Using this method of importing references allows you to add many references at an instant. However, this method of adding references will not provide you with the PDF. Please use the import PDF method if you need the PDF in your EndNote library. For this demonstration, I'll be using three databases, NUS Libraries Find More, PubMed, and Google Scholar to show how the import RS file method works. Before I demonstrate how to import references into EndNote using this method, let me explain the general workflow of this method of adding references. First, do a search in the database of your choice. Once you have done your search, shortlist the results you want by selecting the checkbox or radio button beside that particular result. Once you're done, search for the export to or send to function. The name of the function and where it is located depends on the user interface of the database you're using. The database will then generate a .rs file, which you can then import into EndNote by double-clicking on it. You can also import it into EndNote by clicking on File, Import, and then File. Let's start with Find More first. First, make sure you open EndNote and then do a search in Find More. I'm going to use Singapore General Elections as a search term. Once you have done your search and the search results populate your browser, you can start shortlisting the articles that you want. To shortlist articles in Find More, click on the file icon at the right side of the result. Different databases use different icons. Some might be a checkbox or a radio button, so please look out for that. I shortlisted 5 articles, and once you have shortlisted the articles you want, you can start exporting it out from the database. For Find More, you will click on the temporary folder on the top right hand corner. As the other databases have different user interface, the user experience might be different. However, you are essentially looking for a temporary folder, send to or export to function. Once you're in the temporary folder of Find More, click on export to and select export to EndNote, and Find More will generate a .rs file for you to download. The other databases you may use may have different options and use different labels when exporting the records. But in general, you are looking for the option to export as a .rs file or export to EndNote, which will generate a .rs file. Once you're done with exporting the .rs file, you can double-click on it to import it into EndNote. If you're having issues, you can also import the .rs file by opening up EndNote, clicking on File, Import, and then Import the file. Make sure the import option is set to Reference Manager bracket RIS, and then search for the file to bring it in. For Mac users, the steps are similar. However, if you're having issues importing the .rs file, you can click on File, Import. Make sure to click on Options, and make sure that the import option is set to Reference Manager bracket RIS before importing the .rs file. For PubMed, the steps are largely similar. First, head to PubMed and then do a search. I am going to keep things simple and use the term heart attack. Once you have done your search, you can shortlist the articles you want by clicking on the checkbox beside the result. Next, click on Send To and select Citation Manager. PubMed will create a .nbib file, which you can import into EndNote by double-clicking on it. If that does not work, open EndNote, click on File, Import, Import the file. Make sure the import option is set to Multi-Filter Special. If not, you have issues importing the .nbib file. Once you have done that, bring in the .nbib file, and EndNote will handle the rest. For Mac users, the steps are similar. However, if you're having issues importing the .nbib file, you can click on File, Import, make sure to click on Options, and please ensure that the import option is set to Multi-Filter Special before importing the .nbib file. The third and final database I will demonstrate is Google Scholar. The steps here are slightly different. First, head to Google Scholar, and once you are there, just do a search. Unlike the other databases, Google Scholar only allows you to export one reference at a time. To export the reference, click on the quotation mark and a pop-up will appear. Select EndNote and Google Scholar will generate a .env file. Double-click on it and it should be imported into EndNote. If it does not work, open EndNote, click on File, Import, import the file. Make sure the import option is set to EndNote Import before importing the .env file into EndNote. For Mac users, if you are having issues importing the .env file, you can click on File, Import. Make sure to click on Options, and please ensure that the import option is set to EndNote Import before importing the .env file into EndNote. I hope that this lengthy video has shown you how to export references from databases into EndNote using the import RS file method. Please visit our EndNote library guide if you want to know more about using EndNote. You can also email us at askalib@nus.edu.sg if you need further assistance.